I'm Rebecca Marmore. I'm a Johns Hopkins vascular surgeon. I practice out of Howard County General Hospital. A deep vein thrombosis is a blood clot. Typically arises in the lower leg. Can manifest with pain and swelling in the foot or leg. Its most serious consequence, however, is something called a pulmonary embolus, where some of the blood clot actually breaks free and goes to the lung. It can be a life-threatening condition. Risk factors for DVT include hypercoagulable state. So for patients who have history of a prior blood clot, have a history of multiple spontaneous abortions, these are patients who likely have thicker blood than normal, and they're at risk for DVT. Other risk factors include prolonged immobility. This can be after long travel, so patients who just got in from a flight from Australia are at risk for DVT. But prolonged immobility can also be a result of a hospitalization or a broken bone. Trauma, surgery, cancer, these are also well-established risk factors for DVT. DVT is definitely considered a medical emergency. Although the pain and swelling in the leg may be uncomfortable or annoying, it's a serious condition because if the blood clot breaks off and travels to the lung, that can be a life-threatening condition. Traditional treatment for DVT includes blood thinners. We now have a variety of blood thinners. Some of them require levels are checked, such as Coumadin, that's the traditional one. Very rarely, patients may benefit from removal of the blood clot in their leg. And if they develop a very serious pulmonary embolus with symptoms making them seriously ill, they may require surgical intervention to treat that. So patients who have DVTs, some of them just might be one random episode, maybe related to an episode of prolonged immobility, such as a long transatlantic flight. However, for patients who have hypercoagulable disorders, patients who have cancer, and patients with underlying conditions that make them more likely to develop blood clots, they can recur. The duration of anticoagulation is a complicated medical decision. It's usually made in conjunction with a patient's hematologist, primary care doctor, and sometimes a vascular surgeon.